Welcome to this new gameplay of Forza 6. And as you can see, I'm in the My Cars menu trying to select the car that I will drive. I'll drive this car this episode, obviously, but I'll just have to choose which car I'm going to drive. It'll take quite a long time, but I'll find it. And today's car, I think it will be... No, I made a video on this one already. This car could be good. Yeah, this car would be the best choice. At least for me. I'd maybe choose another car over this, but this was just a car that I found very perfect for this video, because we're going to make a drift wheel. And you all know how it's going to go. We're going to upgrade it in a way that it can drift. But in this way, we're going to go cheapskate. That means that, well, engine swaps will be far too expensive for me, because I don't have enough money to buy this. Or wait, maybe I have. I can check my inbox to see if I've got some gifts. Okay, 7,000... nothing, okay. What's that thing? Oh, very useful for marketing, you know. Let's just find this car in free play. Just with zero drivers. Just to check its drag time or something. We'll just test its speed and its acceleration and stuff. Just for a comparison. We'll go to the track. We'll go to the Top Gear track. We'll go to this outer loop. Because it's the outer loop of the track, so yeah. It makes sense. You know, it makes sense that I'm making a lap there. Sunny and cars. How many cars am I going to have besides me? We can drive alone. We can drive alone. Let's just do 2 laps. No, 3 laps. And no collision. Yes. So let's start the race, and now we're going to try and race this car around the Top Gear track, at least the outer loop of the track. And now we're in. Let's just, to make it fair, we'll just disable all the things that I have on. More fair to the other car, because then it can get far more horsepower, because we'll make it more powerful, the other car, so then it will have more of a boost from that.
I don't know.
gun, 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 I swear. Low that gun. me now! I thought I only got like 100,000 from that. I got like 200,000 over that. Actually, maybe like something with... How much did I have? We'll just say that I got almost like 300,000 something, maybe. No, we actually got more than 300,000. I'm not sure. I don't remember what we had before this, so... Which one should we go for? I think it's this one. Just because it's a rotary engine. And you can't like buy a car like this without a rotary engine. Like that's completely useless. I'm not like saying something to the people who have rotary in this car. I'm just saying that you actually need a rotary in these cars because that's just the cost of it. Even though the car originally doesn't have rotary, it doesn't mean it doesn't want to have rotaries, you know? Every car likes to have rotors because it's much faster and much more efficient for its volume, but also it's also much less reliable, and it's also a less viable choice for the people who like to have a reliable car. And I understand that, but if you want speed, of course cylinders are good for the reliability part, but if you just want speed, a lot of rotors would suit you just fine because the size is perfect for your needs. Like if you need a small engine, if you want to fit a big motor in a small engine or a big acting one, you should rather get like a high revving rotary engine than a low revving piston engine. Put some street tires because they'll give you more grip to drift. Sounds a bit weird, but still makes quite a lot of sense. Like that sums up its sense. Just what I said sums it up because that sentence was weirder than the actual thing. Spoiler, we don't need spoilers. Let's test drive it in the same track, but this time we'll go and perfectly tune it for our needs, which is drifting. And the same track, no difference. The only difference is that I'm doing this in test mode instead of the normal mode that I was doing for a few minutes ago. Now we're playing it, but we're just waiting for the loading time. And the loading time's gone. Oh, and this car is so fast. Fast. And now it's going crazy. I'm really curious if this car's acceleration. I think it's over. Like almost Bugatti level, I think. Let's see. No, it's not even close. I think it's because of everything else that causes the grip loss because the car is too light. Yes, I understood. I'm making the car slower, but I'm actually reducing the tire pressure because that'll make the car drift better. I think symmetrical will fit good. And a little bit longer gears actually. took no time. And it does nothing to the acceleration either, so. It does a little bit. I don't know which way though. Maybe a little bit. I don't even know. If it makes, it makes a very minor difference. So. Let's see. The front camber is 0.5 and the rear camber is 2. And it will go slightly out. No, no, no. Yes. Orient. Let's just say out. And increase casper angle. And then the anti-roll bars, which I will slip in. And all of these two, no. Maybe. Some of them. Reduce this, though. Take this, max it out. Put this, max it out. Same on both. Apply. Go out. And and ripping around this corner. broken all their engines with this thing. What? Well, because the rotary engines are screaming in my face because they are too powerful. Almost too powerful. But I'll still stay with these rotaries. Sorry, I had to plug in my headphones again. I tripped on them. No, I didn't trip on them. My feet got caught in it. Well, not my feet. I don't know how, but I unplugged it. I don't even know how I got it through there. Maybe because I was switching positions so fast. Because I can never find one position to play the game at. Because when I play the game in this position, I can talk to you very loudly, but then I can't play the game as well as I was sitting normally. So it's almost like a choice. So this one's the best for the viewers, but I don't care about myself because, well, the viewers are almost like a miniature version, not in literal size, but in value of this video. Like, you have a small value to this video, but since I made the video, I have a higher value, because it's just like saying, like, the boss is a higher value than the fans of the boss. I mean, it's almost exactly like it. So, the dragon low and flat. Well, I should say that if the car wasn't as fast, but it is really fast. Maybe we should be a little bit less? Like, maybe we should make it a little bit heavier. We could try. It's okay. We can switch it back later. We'll put on the roll cage and we'll turn off these. I don't really think it will make a very big difference. But it might make a very big grip difference, because it's very different from when you have this and when you have something else, like the full weight loss thing that loses 300 pounds and makes your car super light. I can definitely feel something. Yes, the car is a lot less vicious and a lot more vicious. Yeah, it's like 100 times. Yeah. I mean, the speed is lower, but everything else is higher. The only thing that's lower is the speed that we're exiting the track at, but everything else seems to be improved in some way, in some degree. I could say. Yes. Let's just make an all-wheel drive version drag build. And it would be so much better, because it would have all-wheel drive, it wouldn't slip, it would have incredible acceleration, and control of the car rather than drifting it on every corner. Yeah, it would make quite a lot of sense if I did that. Even drifting is better with all-wheel drive. What's the point of having rear-wheel drive? Well, that's in Forza at least. In every other game, having rear-wheel drive is almost like being a handling master. Because rear-wheel drive will apparently give you everything that all-wheel drive has, but give you rather better handling. And also, an incredible amount of beautiful cars to actually drive with rear-wheel drive. But Forza somehow thinks that all-wheel drive is 100 times better than rear-wheel drive and everything. And in every game apart from The Crew, that is true. And I'm talking about the other thing with the rear-wheel drive is the best. Apart from Forza and in The Crew, obviously. Because in The Crew, front-wheel drive is the best. Because basically, front-wheel drive cars can swing in the best way, or not swing, but handle in the best way possible. Because it's more of a street style than the ones that can actually drift. But front wheel drive eliminates the fact that you can accelerate, but that is non-existent, because in The Crew you almost have no handling issues whatsoever. So The Crew is almost like an arcade game then, because front wheel drive would be 100 times better than rear wheel drive in almost all the aspects apart from the cars that you can choose from. Because the car that you can choose from is some street cars and maybe some economy cars, and that's it. Maybe some wannabe sports cars that use front wheel drive because they're on the cheap. And that was my, I don't know how many minutes talk of, well, only a comparison of The Crew, Forza, and all the other racing games. And the fact that I said that the rear-wheel drive was bad in The Crew and Forza, I'm not lying, but somewhat, but the rear-wheel drive that is good is somewhat true, because with rear-wheel drive you can actually drift reverse entries without problems, and in all-wheel drive you get far too much grip, and for the expense of having far better controls. But you know, rear-wheel drive is far more loose and risky than all-wheel drive. And that's why they have made two lobby sessions, one with the rear-wheel drive cars only, and one with all drive type cars. In Forza at least. So, enough gibberish, now we will go and test the car. On the racing track, yes, the test track, drag race, and now we'll tune it to the best acceleration possible for this type of engine. So we know a little bit more information about this engine. It's a pretty non-grippy engine. It doesn't want so much grip. It looks like it wants to drift every time I make it go. And it's almost impossible to determine how much speed I have to enter the corners at in a race. because I forgot to install the driver. I can definitely say that it's much more controllable and much more safe than the other car. But the gearing feels a little bit short, to be honest. And for that, we got a slower time. Hope you like my video, by the way. So, let's go. What was the problem again? Oh yeah, this. So yeah, it was a bit awkward because I've got to install this again, and I wasted my money on making a freaking rip build that's completely useless. So this video will be a change title from drift build to drag build. And the only reason being that I can't drift. The car can drift, fine. The tune can be done, but I can't. And I can't drift. Because I am basically a screaming child that knows nothing about Forza. Yeah, you could say it. I will not offend you if you say that in the comments. Or I will not be offended. I should rather say. Because I said it in the video and I gave you the rights to say that. And I won't even call YouTube, and I won't even say anything about it if you do it. No matter the consequence, okay? No matter the consequence, you can say it if you watch the part, if you watch this part of the video. Hope this works, because most of the time my videos don't work. I don't know why. It's just doesn't work. It definitely feels faster, but in a different way. It feels a bit close to snap. I did that on purpose. I did that on that made the car drift a little bit that I did on purpose. I'm not that bad. Let's try something a bit longer and something that is actually a circuit and not a straight line, goddammit. Let's try the Catalunya circuit and let's try to be original this time and do the Grand Prix circuit, because if I did this, you would cry. Because I'm not doing the real circuit, and you'd say that I'm still in school because I'm doing the school circuit. Okay, I won't do that one, even though I like it more than this one. And I don't even know if you care about the circuit I'm using, but, you know, just to be sure, I'm doing this. Okay, now we're in the race. But first, we will try to do a burnout to burn out the tires. It's a rotary engine. tell the difference between Subaru and a Mazda. Then I could say that you're not an enthusiast at all, because everyone could tell the difference between Subaru and a Mazda engine. And this is the difference. This is the difference. The difference is that Mazdas are whining with rage, when Subarus are brutal monsters that go overdrive and grip to the ground so much that you can even drive in the mud without any problems. And the Mazda style is the completely opposite. Not completely the opposite. Both have quite a lot of horsepower, but they use a completely different type of engine. Even the type of engine is different. Almost everyone uses the same type of engine apart from Mazda, because Mazda actually uses rotary engines, well, generic engine type engine makers, mixed engines with pistons, just like every other engine in the world apart from Mazda. Well, not every other engine, but most of the engines on the market, I can guarantee you, they are not rotary. But I can tell you that rotary isn't bad, but it's just not reliable. That's the problem. Think about this. You've got one hair dryer that is normal and works on a fan and a heater. And then there's one that uses suction technology to actually suck in the air and push it into your hair, but the fan can easily get damaged. What could you do then? Would you buy the one that has the suction technology, or would you buy the one that has the blowing technology like normal? Well, that's almost a choice for the people who like rotary engines or piston engines, while the suction technology is not reliable but has much better performance because it actually sucks in the air rather than blowing it and potentially not getting all the energy because you're actually sucking from the other side. Or you could select for the more reliable option that loses a lot more of its power very quickly. But it's also 100 times more reliable because you at least have a less percent chance of it breaking down in the middle of you cleaning your hair. Or you could choose between those. But I'm really thinking that you couldn't choose from those because that technology doesn't exist, because it's rather inconvenient to do something like that. We don't even need to do something like that. I don't think I'm sick. It's just because I have dry throat or something. So, even though this was quite a disappointing video, I hope you liked it still, and I hope you comment my videos and subscribe to me, because that's what you're supposed to do. Just kidding. Just do what you want, and even if you dislike, I won't hate you, because this video deserves to be disliked, you know. Every video deserves to be somewhat disliked by some person. Apart from some videos about some topics that just are so right or so good that they're not deserved to be disliked by one person in the world. But that video is so rare that I doubt that any of us will make such a video like that. But anyways, now we've fallen into a completely new topic. And let's just get into the topic again, and let's just wave a goodbye and hope that the next video will be better than this one.